last 24 hours, what our eyes have witnessed, wallahi, first and foremost, is unprecedented. Secondly, at this most blessed moment of Yawm al-Jum'ah, during the khutbah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy upon all those who have lost their lives. Say Ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant every single one of those Jannah. Not just Jannah, but Al-Firdaus, Al-A'la. Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. May He grant their families and their loved ones and the entire Muslim Ummah some form of peace, some form of mercy. May Allah grant us some form of forgiveness, some form of lesson, some form of ibrah from this. And I want to dwell upon this today, as there is no other topic but this topic of mention. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says first and foremost, وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَنْ يُقْتَلُ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتٍ بَلْ أَحْيَاءٍ. Allah says that do not say about those whom are killed or die in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the path of Allah, that they are dead. By Allah, they are not dead. بَلْ أَحْيَاءٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. But these people are what? They are alive. The shuhada and the martyrs are alive with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in different places Allah ends the similar verse like this differently. In one place, He says that we do not know what the shu'ur is. We do not understand what this means in terms of being alive. Allah Himself knows. And in another place Allah says, بَلْ عِنْدَهُمْ يُرْزَقُونَ, that Allah continues to sustain them wherever they may be and whatever that may mean, inshaAllah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the level of the shuhada as well, inshaAllah, when it comes to our death. But ikhwanuna, a moment of reflection. And ikhwan, wallahi, we didn't have any time to prepare this khutbah. I literally walked in last moment the entire night. From around about 3 a.m.-ish, when I started to see the headlines, I started to ask myself that question, that do I want to be in Jum'ah tomorrow? Do I want to stand in Jum'ah tomorrow in front of this congregation? And see, shaitan is clever. At the most beloved and beautiful time of night, shaitan was whispering, the devil was telling me, to fear something, to not want to go into Edmonton today. But ikhwanuna, in the face of adversity, we are Muslims, alhamdulillah. And Muslims, we know one thing. We do not fear any creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala above Allah. Correct? We only fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ikhwan. So whatever the adversity may be that comes in front of us, whatever it may be, the only one we fear is Rabbul Alameen, is the one who owns the entirety of this universe, the one who controls the entirety of creation, the one who gave that very group of people the tawfiq to be in the masjid, the one who allowed those people to commit whatever atrocity that it was. Everything is with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the ikhwanuna, we believe this in totality. Allah is just, and His justice will always reign. Whatever happened in the early hours of the morning, for us the early hours of the morning, and for them Salatul Jum'ah, whatever happened at that time only happened by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And no doubt, understand this, my brothers and sisters, that every single one of us has a fixed and appointed time of death. Only Allah knows what this is. And whenever it may come, we must be prepared. Those brothers and sisters did not know. Those youngsters who were in the masjid did not know that they were going for the final salah of their lives. They did not know they would not be able to pray Salatul Jum'ah, that this would happen before prior to Salatul Jum'ah. They did not know that this would be the last time they were saying goodbye to their families as they were walking to the masjid. They did not know that that was the last time that they would look at their phones and say hi or bye to someone before this was about to happen. No one knows what time, what place, how and where we will go. But ikhwanuna, in the face of tribulation, and at a time when our hearts are filled with sorrow, at a time when our eyes are welled with tears, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, first and foremost, that Ya Allah, forgive us. For we do not know when you will call us. Ya Allah, forgive us. Make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the first lesson we take from today. That Ya Allah, we will have to meet you tomorrow on Yawm al-Qiyamah. Ya Allah, tomorrow we will have to face your angels in the grave, Ya Allah. We do not know what our state will be. For those we pray Allah grant them the highest of Jannah. Why? Because already in the dunya they have the status of a martyr. And we pray that tomorrow on Yawm al-Qiyamah Allah will raise them with the shuhada of Badr, with the shuhada of Uhud inshaAllah. But ikhwanuna, I tell you something, when these things happen, of course it hurts. Why does it hurt? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala established brotherhood between us. Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخْوَيْكُمْ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Let's split this verse into four parts. The first, Allah establishes brotherhood. What does He say? That you are brothers. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. Indeed, you are brothers of one another. You are brothers and sisters to one another. Allah establishes this for us. This isn't something we established. This isn't something that comes from our tradition as human beings. No, this comes from Allah. This is divine. Allah says that you and I are brothers, so we accept that you and I are brothers. فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخْوَيْكُمْ. Settle your differences amongst each other. No doubt, know that we are different in color, we are different in size, we are different in language, but by our hearts, by Allah, we are connected.